one. Just gonna set this in my pocket. Don't let me forget I have it. Okay, so I'm going to read an excerpt tonight from my debut novel, Phileas Flint. Before I do, a little context would definitely help. This is set on a planet where magic exists. Snark is a swear word. And people don't have phones because they have teleporting messenger squirrels, of course. On this planet, there is a religion that follows a god named Zorda. And followers of this religion are called Zords. And this religion has two main tenets. One is they really value physical strength, which means that instead of temples that are set up for prayer, their worship areas are more like arenas or worship halls, which are basically huge community gyms. The second tenet of their faith is that they observe gender-neutral expression. So they use the pronoun A, which works just like the singular they pronoun. Now, the section that I'm going to read is from the perspective of a character who is a Zord. And this character's name is Nor the Hawk Dixon. And Nor has a very interesting phobia, which you'll probably figure out what it is during this reading. Also, there's a very strong accent. I've lived in the American South for about a decade, so Nor's accent is based very heavily on that. Okay. With Zorda as my strength, ain't nothing can stand my way. My fist connected with that there punching bag at 12 beats per second. There was a reader on the wall that told me so. I wiped a trickle of sweat off my forehead and went at the bag again. The team animal force gym was hotter than a lava pit and smelled worse than a rat's nest, but at least it wasn't near as proud as my worship hall normally was. The people here was less nosy, too. Worship halls was always rife with gossip. I hit the bag. 13 beats per second. Of course, it didn't help none that I was the only living descendant of the Amorphite Dixon. I punched the bag hard. Some things was hard to live up to. I hit the bag again. It could be worse, though. I could still be dealing with them closed-minded folk back in Meadowland. I switched to kicking, my right leg slapping against the canvas at 10 beats per second. Sort of bless it, I knew I could do better than that. I kicked again, 11 beats per second. I grunted. Ain't no way I'd win the lightweight title off of Sinclair next week moving that slow. I switched legs. 13 beats per second. Now that was downright annoying. A year of full-on physical therapy after my knee surgery, my right leg still couldn't move for sticks. I kicked again. 11. Again. 11. Coach done come up behind me. 11. 11. 11. Coached them across their arms. I don't know about that right leg of yours, Dixon. We still have time to cancel the fight. I wiped the sweat out of my eyes. Oh, don't you worry yourself, none, Coach. I'll be ready for him. Coach narrowed her eyes. Prove it on the map, then. Max needs a sparring partner. Of course he did. I nodded and adjusted my glove straps. Didn't need them flying off and poking Max in the eye. I done made my way over the center mat and sit on my headgear. Max was already waiting for me, hopping up and down the corner like a kangaroo. Abe got a pro last year while I'd been recovering. I really hated him for that. It wasn't a real Zord-like sentiment, but he got right under my skin with their spiky blonde hair and fake green tattoos. They had a downright punchable face, too. I got up on that there mat and we circled each other good and proper. We was nothing more than two bodies hunting lines of attack. Adrenaline done rushed through me like sweat streaming down skin. This was the warrior's way. Never seeking violence, but always prepared for when it done come. Coach eyed us up real good. Ready? And begin! I pressed pray the sword for strength and honor. Dixon, keep your hands up, Coach shouted from the corner. I growled and pulled my fists up right quick. Then I changed my stance, switching from standard to line foot. That would keep Max guessing. And it did, too. Until it did. While I was busy setting up a rat ear double punch, it was doing the mount on which my feet was leading. My punch landed square in your gut, but Ace sent a Jimmy Jack kick into my weak front leg. I stumbled, and Max Dunn leaped into a mountain lion takedown and swept me clean to the mat. That wasn't no problem, though, because my ground game was fire. Coach was not pleased. Dixon, don't let him control when you go to the mat. Focus! Run. I done pulled Max into a full throttle guard and rained punches all over that smug little face. It went like a dip snark to get out, but I switched to a kite snake choke and squeezed real good. But Max shifted her hips and popped her head right out. Then he pinned my arms down to the ground. Ooh, did that boil my blood. You can't keep doing this, Dixon. He's walking all over you. Get your head in the game. I kicked hard at Max's abdomen, wrenched my arms free, and rolled away quick as a cat. It backed up a few steps while I took to my feet, like I was some kid, and he was giving me permission? I clenched my jaw. Now, this here wasn't about no control, this was about speed. See, I needed to fly, just like my namesake. I circled Max again, nice and slow, while thinking about them ancient stories. Nor had been Morphy Dixon's favorite hunting hawk. Back in the days of the Revolution, my great-great-great-grandmaster done sent that bird with secret messages to rebel commanders all over Parsa. That there hawk done made those flights so quick that the only thing today that even compared to them was them teleported messenger squirrels. But Nor hadn't been some brainless messenger neither. Ada flew down into enemy lines and single-wingedly drove them clean out of the rebel camps. Zora had done blessed that bird with something special, and my nickname wasn't the hawk for nothing. Tired of circling, I closed in for a brawl. Faking a left punch, I sent in a right that banged on her ribs good and proper. Max wobbled himself back a few steps. Then he stood up tall and winked at me. Now all thoughts of Zorda in battle whooshed right on out of my head. Winking just ain't natural. What kind of person blinked with one eye when Zorda done gave you two perfectly good ones? Perverts and serial killers, that was who. Catching me by surprise, Max done unleashed a flurry of punches that I was too snarking disoriented to block. Every blow was a shock to my system and my head done snapped itself back. Shock melted into confusion. Confusion turned into darkness, and then I was sleeping. Hey, Nick, sleeping? Coach peered down at me. Are you all right? Yeah, fine, I mumbled. You've got to get over that fear, Dixon. If you don't, you'll lose the match before it ever starts, just like last time. Shuddering, I got up to my feet. I'll go again. I'm ready. Max shook her head. I don't know, Noah. I'm pretty beat. Liar. He didn't even look winded. I can do it. Let's go. Like snarks you will, Coach said. You need to go get your noggin unshook. Go meditate or something. I narrowed my eyes. Zords don't sit and stare at walls. I raised my hand in the air. We fight! Max smirked. All right, Cupcake, I think someone needs to go home. Coach threw up their hands. Don't provoke her, Max. I clenched my fists and spat through gritted teeth. I ain't no her, I'm a Zord. Coach waved me off, snarking Zords. Glaring at them in disgust, I stomped off to the locker rooms. Max sniggered behind my back. Oh, we'd get it next time, right in the face. And also, I recently published this book by my brother, Dr. Anthony Luis Sanchez Cruz, for anyone who happens to know somebody who speaks Spanish and is interested in the folkloric music of Argentina. and Rico. There will be an English version at some point, but both of these are available for sale online and wherever books are sold.
Does anybody have any questions for Ditrie?
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead.
So, have you done martial arts kinds of things?
No. I took about 3 or 4 months of kickboxing years ago. But I actually had to do a lot of research for the fight scenes because this was MMA and there were a lot of things that I was not advanced enough to understand. And then I had to translate those into fake fantasy named moves. So all of the moves are based on real world, earth world equivalents, but I had a lot of fun with naming them after different animals, because I thought that was fun.
After, sorry, after?
Different animals.
Oh, okay. Any other questions?
Yes.
How did you get the idea for this book? It sounds like really interesting.
Okay, so I've had this idea since I was in college of like an expanded universe, and part of, well, I won't give that away because I might write it one day. And I started writing a book that was a prequel to that idea, and it was awful. I hated it. So then I wrote a book that was a prequel to that one, and that's this one. So in this universe, there are actually multiple dimensions that are nested, and so there are some civilizations that are advanced enough to house entire universes on a technological device. So this planet is actually in a universe that is on a device that is owned by a girl in a family, and she's really upset because her brother did something that messed up basically their version of the internet and got a virus on her universe grower, and so every sentient being on that piece of technology is in danger of dying, because if the code kills off people, and so there are layers of universes and reality, and it was very, very fun to write. Any other questions? Yes.
Just a comment. What an imagination!
Thank you.
So you must be a fan of the Matrix, though.
I've actually never seen any other season.
Yeah, I've just seen it.
But I do love Plato's Cave, which is kind of the same concept, right?
Yes, yes. Do you like Harry Potter?
Yes.
Were you like me where you couldn't stop reading it? You were sitting there cooking supper reading?
Yes, yes. It's funny because I was living with my family when those books were still coming out, and sometimes I would buy the next book for my brother to read as a gift for him, because I knew he would love the series, and then I was like, can I borrow that? Because he doesn't read at the same pace that I do, and so I would borrow it and hog it and then read the whole thing and then give it back to him, and he'd get so mad.